Approaching Torches Island. You're the one they call Torch.
Shay Vissla. That little nickname the locals came up with. Hell if I know why.
You recently had a falling out with the Revanites and the Nova Blades. I could use your help.
I'm sure you could, Jedi. Tell you what. Instead of whatever grand gesture of cooperation you thought might happen here, why don't we try something a little different? Been a while since I had a decent challenge. I'm taking this opportunity to show my clan how it's done.
Ah! Not bad.
Not bad at all. Been a while since someone's given me a fight like that. You should be proud.
You're telling me this was all just a fun little sparring match for you?
Well, me, my clan, and our beasts. So I wouldn't call it little, really. Now then, I'd say you earned some answers. It was the Revanites you were asking about, right? We were the ones who hooked them up with the Nova Blades. Even helped them win a scrap or two. Once they started the secret manipulating all-out war nonsense, I pulled us out. I've had my fill of war.
A Mandalorian who's tired of war. I thought fighting was your whole life.
Fighting, yes. War. I guess it depends on who you ask. I think it's boring. You spend most of your time waiting around between battles, and when they finally happen, it's just a bunch of random killing. I prefer my fights sporting, or at least interesting.
And the Revanites don't?
Nope. They stack the deck as much as they can. I do know they've got a whole fleet of warships tucked away somewhere on this planet. Never gave me any real details or coordinates, but they're here. If you want to find them and smash them up, more power to you. I liked this place a lot better before they showed up.
Want to hand over a ride to replace the one you shot down?
Plenty of speeders around this place. Take whichever you want. Let's get you patched up, Vode. I've been going too easy on you.
We can't afford to be so reckless, Jakaro. Losing Theron is bad enough. What if we'd lost you too?
Now, everyone, stay calm. Queen Lena of Onderon once faced a similar predicament, and her solution was quite creative.
Shut up, droid!
What's going on? Where's Theron?
He was captured. The Nova Blades data listed a Revanite safe house here in town, and when we tried to investigate... Theron is the only one the Revanites saw. They may not know about the rest of us. If so, we need to maintain that advantage.
You made a tough call, but I think it was probably the right one.
I really think you're all much too worried. They took him alive! That's a good sign. They're probably just torturing him a bit. Maybe doing some interrogation, where He could tell them about us. Oh, no!
That won't be an issue. Theron has several discreet implants to help him ignore pain and chemical manipulation.
A powerful Force user may still be able to learn what he knows.
I've never been able to... Yes, I've tried. I'm sure it's no surprise. Theron's mind is highly ordered, very resolute, probably due to his childhood training by the Jedi. He'll keep our secrets and we will rescue him. But right now, we need to focus and think it all through, just like he would.
You're right. We need to stick to the mission. When we find the Revanites, we'll find Theron.
Precisely. If we're fortunate, he may even learn a bit about their plans. Now, what did you learn from the Mandalorians?
Revan has a hidden fleet here on Rishi. He's preparing for some kind of battle.
A hidden fleet. Pirates altering shipping lanes. That's it. They aren't just affecting the shipping lanes. They're also changing Imperial and Republic patrol paths.
Revan is trying to draw them into a battle.
Here, over Rishi. With his own ships in the mix, both fleets could be devastated.
That must be his goal. Weakening both sides so that he can make his own play.
We have to find some way to interfere.
I know where to find them! After they caught Theron, I intercepted their transmissions. After that, triangulating their base was a simple calculation. I completed it almost 87 seconds ago. They're on a small island not far from here. The native Rishi have a trading village on the same island. I'm sure they'd give us comfortable lodging.
Then let's go.
We need to clean up any trail we might have left here. You go on, we'll meet you shortly.
Oh, I used to love cleaning.
Greetings. We watched you fighting on the beach. The other off-worlders were very unkind. We are much friendlier. Have you come to trade? Do you need lodgings? Outsiders are always welcome here.
Thank you for the warm welcome. I'm surprised you're so open to outsiders.
We love outsiders. You all have such interesting things to say. An entirely new off-worlder. We've never encountered your language. Please, speak more.
Oh, there's no need for that, I assure you. I can speak quite well for both of us. Allow me to introduce...
The second head speaks too. I assumed it was decorative. How fascinating.
You mentioned the other off-worlders earlier. The ones who attacked me. What do you know about them?
We don't know much. I'm afraid they usually avoid us. It seems a little rude, but we know that our ways are different. They have some camps on the island. They wear different colors, dark in one, light in the other, but they all work together, like you.
Revanites. Some from the Republic, some from the Empire.
I think you're right. I'm still going over the data Theron decoded from the Nova Blades. Go to those camps and interfere any way you can.
Save the reading for later. It'd be nice to have you along for once.
I'd like to, but I really don't think you'll need my help. My time is better spent here. May the Force serve you well.
All right, you're here.
You got us. What's it gonna be, Jedi? Did you come to spout your narrow-minded drivel? Or do you have something more permanent in mind?
If you didn't want to hear my drivel, you'd have opened fire already. You want to talk this through.
We don't have anything to talk about. We've sworn to overthrow the governments who've kept the galaxy divided for so long. To end this war. How can you possibly justify standing in our way?
You're betraying the Republic, causing thousands of deaths, all on the word of a single madman.
Revan sees through the lies. He knows how to save the galaxy.
From what? War? Revan's been fighting this war for centuries. He's obsessed with it. The man you're following says he's going to save us all. But he's manipulating and killing quite a lot of us along the way. Will there be anyone left to save when he's done?
I don't know. What do you want from me? Huh? Why are you saying all of this?
I believe you want to do what's right. And if you go back to the Republic, you still can.
You're serious? Just like that, huh? After everything that's happened.
Why not?
This is crazy. All right. I can't speak for everyone, but I'll give the Republic one last shot.
We're with you, Cap.
Thanks. For all this. And good luck.
With all of the security alerts, I was expecting more. Let's settle this, Jedi, before any more time is wasted with your pointless interruption.
Enough blood has been spilled on Revan's account. We can stop that if we work together.
I'm afraid I'm not interested.
You're back. The Rishi told us about some disturbances in the camps.
I dealt with them both. Theron is being held in another Revanite stronghold nearby. Do we know anything about it?
The Valley facility. We just learned about it ourselves. The Rishi tell us there are quite a few starships hidden in the vicinity.
Revan's fleet.
Precisely. And according to the Nova Blade's data logs, his plan is moving swiftly. Fleets from the Empire and Republic are approaching as we speak. These aren't just small patrol groups. Both navies have gathered their most powerful warships. They're being overseen directly by Darth Maar and Satil Shan.
We know the Revanite infiltration goes pretty high, but surely not those two.
I haven't gotten far enough into the Nova Blade's data to know either way. I agree with you, though. It seems highly unlikely.
What do we know about the Revanite facility?
It seems to be their primary operating center on Rishi. Heavy security with only one clear path of approach. You'll have to attack straight on if we're to have any hope of rescuing Theron and stopping this fleet battle.
Then that's what I'll do.
We'll assist you any way that we can. May the Force serve you well. And in. Theron's toys make all of this slicing much simpler than I'd imagined.
Can you find any hard data on his location?
Let's see. Here we are. Recorded interrogation sessions. Coordinates are included. I'll forward them along.
What about Revan?
No information either way. I'd advise caution.
Another pointless attack.
Where's Theron?
He and I have had some interesting conversations. My own flesh and blood, completely blind to the sacrifices I've made. I've struggled for centuries to preserve the galaxy, to protect future generations from the most destructive evil that's ever existed. How can none of you see this?
I will tear this place to the ground if I have to. Where is Theron?
Not far, it seems.
Here. Come on, we have to go. Now.
Theron?
Escaped all on your own. I hoped I would have more time to make you see.
He's got a signal jammer that's blocking all starship communications in the Rishi system. The fleets will come out of hyperspace practically on top of each other. No coordination, saboteurs in every crew. It'll be a massacre.
And at last, the board will be cleared of distractions.
Self-destruct sequence. Come on, we've gotta go.
Look out!
Hello? Is everyone all right?
Lana? You shut down the self-destruct?
I'm beginning to get the hang of this slicing business.
I've created a monster.
You should hurry back. The Republic and the Imperial fleets will be arriving very soon.
I'll return immediately.
I'll meet you there. Need to grab a few things on the way out. Attacking from the air is pointless. The anti-air defenses are much too thick.
I'm afraid of them, doesn't that count? What are our other options?
I think a surface attack is our only real shot at taking the jammer down.
Leave that to me.
Perfect. We'll arrange transportation for you.
You've got to move fast. The fleets are going to be dropping out of hyperspace any second now. The longer we take... the more we lose.
You don't sound good, Theron. Shouldn't you be in a Culto tank instead of planning missions?
Probably, but there's no time. I need to finish slicing the last of these Nova Blade files. They have data on every ship with Revanite infiltrators aboard. As soon as the jamming clears, we'll have to broadcast everything we've got to convince the fleets to cease fire and lock up the Revanites and their crews. One last thing since Lana stepped out. Watch your back. I'm starting to think my little visit to the Revanites might have been her idea.
You think she's working for the Revanites?
No, but I don't think she's putting all her cards on the table either. Just stay alert, all right?
This isn't the time to start dividing ourselves with suspicion. We have to stay united.
Maybe you're right. I don't know. We can sort it all out after that jammer's down. Good luck.
I don't know if you can read me, but I've arrived.
We read you.
Republic Fleet, come in. Do you read me?
Flagship Dauntless here, patching you through to the command deck.
This is Satil Shan. Do we have you to thank for shutting down that jammer?
That, and a whole lot more.
There are traitors hiding on every ship in your fleet. The Imperial ships, too. They're manipulating the battle from both sides.
I'm transmitting the traitors' names now. They're part of a cult. The Order of Revan.
Revan? But he was killed.
Apparently it didn't take.
All ships cease fire. Open a channel to the Imperial Commander.
I've been listening. As ruses go, this is quite creative.
It's the truth. Round up the people from Theron's list and see for yourself.
And if you're correct, what do you propose?
A meeting. Face-to-face on neutral ground.
There's a town on the surface, Raiders Cove. We'll send coordinates for the meeting spot.
Very well.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Would anyone like some refreshments? We have several fine beverages available.
No, thank you. I'm fine.
All right. Off to a good start.
Master Satil, thank you for coming.
Of course.
The Revanite ships have all been scattered, captured, or destroyed. Their accomplices aboard our vessels are in chains. You found a threat and given us the means to root it out. Separately, what do we have to discuss?
Revan is still alive, my lord, and his plans don't stop here.
The Emperor's not dead. Revan thinks he can fix that, but he's wrong, isn't he?
No one person, not even Revan, can truly destroy the Emperor.
I struck the Emperor down myself. I saw him die.
You destroyed his body, even wounded his spirit, perhaps more than anyone before you. But that was not enough. The Emperor's current state is nebulous, incorporeal. To strike at him, Revan will first have to return him to a physical form.
Which is exactly what the Emperor wants.
He will destroy Revan, then move on to the rest of us. In time, he will consume all life in the galaxy.
When he last tried, it was through a ritual that I stopped. How could he possibly repeat it now?
I would rather not give him the opportunity to show us.
We have to stop this. Intercept Revan before he can restore the Emperor's form.
The Emperor's hideaway is a secret, even to the Dark Council.
The fourth moon of Yavin. That's where we'll find Revan. He wanted me to join him there. Never said I couldn't bring a few friends.
According to our data, he still has extensive forces at his disposal. We would stand a better chance of overcoming them together.
No matter what evidence I present, I doubt the Supreme Chancellor will agree to any kind of alliance or truce.
Neither will the Dark Council, but my ships and the soldiers aboard them are loyal to me.
I can convince my troops to maintain a truce. They've seen Revan's threat firsthand.
Then we meet on Yavin 4.
Agreed.
Theron.
We can talk on the way to Yavin. I have some business to finish here.
Thank you for your help. All of you. This can't have been easy.
The conspiracy is finally exposed. We've been hiding our actions from our allies for so long, it's a relief to have everything in the open.
So we can talk about how you threw me to the wolves now?
I made a calculated strategic decision, and it worked, as we can all see now.
And if you had talked to me about it, I would have volunteered, but you didn't even give me a choice.
We couldn't risk the Revanites knowing that your capture was a ploy. You had to be in the dark for the plan to work.
If the Revanites knew your capture was staged, they would have killed you, and we wouldn't have learned Revan's plan. Hiding the truth was probably the best option.
We've got exactly one professional spy in this group. I could have handled it.
I think it's time we moved on. Yavin is a long way from here.
Agreed. Let's get moving.
Lana, stay a moment. We should talk.
Of course.
Enjoy your trip to Yavin!
This is quite a mess I've made, isn't it? The wicked Sith can't be trusted. Just the sentiment we need right now.
I wouldn't be spending so much time around you if I couldn't stand a little bit of intrigue.
Makes sense. The moments we've shared, the connection between us, it's very important to me. I would never want to lose your trust. My strength flows from the passions I embrace, my service to the Empire, and you.
You're very important to me, Lana. Our time together has meant a lot.
But that won't matter in the long run, will it? This truce won't last forever. Even if we succeed, the war won't end. There's no future for us.
I'm not ready to give up, are you?
Not yet. But time is not our ally. We should hurry along.